Hello students, I'm Adrian. I'm here to help you learn Korean. Today, let's make Korean sentences together. I prepared easy sentences to make, so I hope you can understand my lesson today. Shall we start? Let's go! Our first sentence is Seoul is in Korea. How do we make a Seoul is in Korea in Korean? Here are words to use to make the Korean sentence. You can use this word to make the sentence. And this is Seoul, and this is Seoul. Korea and 한국. How to say Korea in Korean? We say 한국, 한국. What comes first in the Korean sentence? Yes, we need to find the subject in the sentence. What is the subject? That's right, Seoul. Seoul is a subject. We say 서울. And next, Seoul is a subject, so you have a marker after the subject. In the last lesson, we studied about subject markers and auxiliary markers. So subject comes with subject markers, E or ka, because the last letter of the subject, ul, has the ending consonant, you have to have E, Seoul-E, Seoul-E. E is a subject marker. Or you can say 서울은, 서울은. 은 is the auxiliary marker. 서울이, 서울은, both are alright, okay? But if you have the subject marker E, you emphasize 서울, the subject. If you have the auxiliary marker, then you emphasize the rest of the word excluding the subject. So you get the idea? So let's continue. 서울이 or 서울은 is in Korea. In Korea. In Korea. How to say in Korea? 한국. Korea, 한국. And in, how to say in Korean? We say 에. 에. You can say 에. In. So in Korea, 한국에. 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 And is, the V verb is, 있어요. You can say 있어요. Is in Korean, 있어요. 있어요 means to be or to stay. To be in one place, to stay in one place. Okay? 한국에 있어요. 서울이 한국에 있어요. And we have the marker 에. 서울이 한국에 있어요. Or 서울은 한국에 있어요. Both are alright. Okay? Let me clarify one more time. If you say 서울이, then you emphasize 서울. If you say 서울은, you emphasize 한국에 있어요. Okay? But the translation of the two different sentences is the same. And another thing we need to mention, 에. What's 에? 에 is the marker which is used with the nouns that shows the information of the location of things or people. Therefore, 에 is followed by the nouns that shows the places. And the nouns show us where things and people are. So in this sentence, 서울이 or 서울은 한국에 있어요. 아하, 한국 is the place where 서울 exists. The noun 한국 gives the information where the 서울 is, and 에 is used with the noun 서울. You cannot say 서울이 한국 있어요. 서울이 한국 있어요. 서울이 한국에 있어요. 서울이 한국에 있어요. You get it? Okay, let's go to the second sentence. Our second English sentence to translate into Korean is the book is in the bag. Okay, good. How to say book in Korean? 책. And how to say bag in Korean? 가방. 가방. And then, what is the subject of the English sentence? That's right, the book. How to say the book in Korean? We say 책. And next, 책이 or 책은, both are correct. in the bag. Bag, how to say bag? 가방. And in, how to say in? You say 에. And is, 있어요. 있어요. 책이, the book is in the bag. 책이 가방에 있어요. Or 책은 가방에 있어요. The book is in the bag. Yes, clear. So the marker 에 is used with the nouns that shows the information of where the book is. Yes, the book is in the bag. 책이 가방에 있어요. Okay? The order of the Korean sentence, we have subject. Next, adverb phrase that shows the location. And this is verb. 있어요. 있어요. Subject, adverb phrase, and verb. Subject, adverb phrase, and verb. But also, you can say 가방에 책이 있어요. 가방에 책이 있어요. This is okay. The order of this sentence is also okay. We have adverb phrase first, and subject, and verb. This order is also okay. And next sentence we try to make in Korean is My younger sister goes to the market. How to say my younger sister in Korean? 여동생. 여동생. We better memorize new word all the time. And market in Korean, 시장. And goes. In Korean, we say 가다. 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 So my younger sister goes to the market. My younger sister, 여동생. 여동생 is a subject and you need a subject marker. 여동생이 to the market. To the market in Korean, 시장에. 시장에 and goes 가요. 가요. 여동생이 시장에 가요. My younger sister goes to the market. Okay. So we have the phrase 시장에. 시장 means market. What is 에 here? The marker 에 we just learned is used with the nouns that shows the information of location of things or people, right? But here 에 has a different usage. It is not showing the information of the location of things. The second usage of the marker 에 is like it is used with the nouns that shows the information of a final destination of people or something. You get the idea? Okay, let me clarify with the sentence. 여동생이 시장에 가요. Where does my sister go? Yes, she goes to the market. So market is the final destination my sister goes to. 시장 is the noun that shows the information of the final destination. 에 used after the 시장. 여동생이 시장에 가요. 여동생이 시장에 가요. The market is the final destination where my sister goes to. And 에 is used right after the noun that shows the information of the final destination. We have the one more example for the second usage of the marker 에. My friend arrives in Korea. How do we say my friend in Korean? 친구. In Korea, 한국. 한국. Arrives, 도착하다. 도착하다. Okay, let's start with the subject. My friend, 친구가. Or 친구는. Both are okay. 친구가, 친구는. In Korea. In Korea, 한국에, 한국에 arrives, 도착해요, 도착해요. 친구가 or 친구는 한국에 도착해요. Okay, mm-hmm. Okay. So, where does my friend arrive? Yes, he arrives in Korea. So Korea is the final destination he arrives. So 한국 is a noun which shows the final destination of the my friend goes to. And A, the marker is followed by the 한국. This is the second usage of the marker A that is used with the nouns that shows the information of the final destination of people or something. Okay? 친구가 한국에 도착해요. 친구는 한국에 도착해요. My friend arrives in Korea. And 도착해요. 도착해요 is the combination 도착하다 plus 해요. Why is the ending attached after 도착하다? Because the verb 도착하다 finish with 하다. 하다. So that's why you have 해요. Our next sentence is My mom cooks at 7 o'clock. How to say my mom in Korean? 엄마. 엄마. 7 o'clock? 7시. 7시. Cooks? 요리하다. 요리하다. Okay, let's get started. It's fun. Okay, we find the subject. My mom. 엄마. And subject marker, 엄마가, 엄마가, 마 doesn't have the ending sound. That's why we have the subject marker, 가, 엄마가. And then at 7 o'clock, 7시에, 7시에, cooks 요리해요, 요리해요, 요리해요 comes from 요리하다 plus 해요. 해요, 해요. The verbs that finish with 하다 are combined with 해요. 해요. Then we have the word 에 after time. So 일곱시에, 일곱시에. What is 에 here? 에 is the marker that is used with the nouns that shows the information of time when things happen. In this sentence, 엄마가 7시에 요리해요. 7시 are the words that shows the information of when my mom cooks. And 에 is followed by the noun 7시. Okay? This is the third usage of how the marker 에 can be used in the sentence. Here's another example for the third usage of 에. I study Korean on Saturday. How do we say Korean in Korean? We say 한국어. 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 Saturday in Korean 토요일. 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 Study in Korean 공부하다. 공부하다. Then we are ready to start. Subject. 저는 on Saturday 토요일 토요일에, 토요일에 한국어를 공부해요. 저는 토요일에 한국어를 공부해요. I study Korean. 저는 한국어를 공부해요. When? When? Yes, that's right. On Saturday. How do we say on Saturday? 토요일에, 토요일에. 토요일 is a noun that has the information of when I study Korean. And the marker 에 is followed by the noun 토요일. So on Saturday, 토요일에. So the 에, the marker, is used with the nouns that shows the information of time when things happen. We practiced making Korean sentences. And we also learned the three usages of the marker 에. First, the marker 에 is used with the nouns that shows the information of the location of things or people. The second, the marker 에 is used with the nouns that shows the information of the final destination where people or things are moving. Lastly, the marker 에 is used with the nouns that shows the information of time when things happen. I hope you learned something from my lesson today. If you learned something from my lesson today, You can write your own sentences down below. Then I can check your sentences. Thank you for watching my video today. If you think my lesson is okay today, please click like and subscribe my channel. That will be a big support for me. I will see you soon. Bye bye.